So I think Estrella Media, we traditionally came from the linear broadcast side of the business. And we have a bunch of different studio content, premium channels. And one of the really interesting things is that with FAST channels, we've seen a huge growth. The thing that has challenges, though, is that with these FAST channels, there's so many different platforms that have different ways of attaining data. So reporting is a big challenge for us, where we, as the publisher, we need this data to make informed decisions about what is our programming, what is our content that we want to show. For us, as the content provider, we are the creators of this content. We want to make sure we are curating our content for the audiences that we're serving. And without that data, which is a lot of times behind walled gardens, it's very hard for us to, you know, be able to have the best experience for our consumers. And I think that's a big challenge that we're facing is when all of these platforms are having their own disparate pieces of data, reporting tools, email reports, it's really difficult for us to be able to compile that and make the best decisions when it comes to content creation.
So you talk about content creation, you also talked about sort of, and there's also the sales angle, and you also talked about data. Seems like there are some challenges to selling media in a converged way. Mm-hmm. So how do you look to your technology partners to help you? Like, what do you look for in a workflow, planning, or a trafficking solution now?
Sure. So I think one of the things is we have so many different touch points. And you're right. So with these different touch points, we talk about video, we talk about audio, we talk about display on so many different platforms. We have iOS, your mobile, you have your CTVs, you have, you know, your Androids. There's so many different devices. And I think going back to that reporting element, some of the best partners are being able to report off of all of these different platforms and distributors and devices, being able to bridge all of that so we can do things like ad serving across all these different channels, all across all these different platforms. We can do reporting, business intelligence, and also being able to do order management for our direct sales business across all of these different channels.
So one thing we didn't talk about was kind of the shift between direct and programmatic. I know that some companies are making the choice to lean away from programmatic sales, whether that's just for video or for their full sort of inventory portfolio. Others are leaning in and working with platforms that let them sell both programmatic and direct. Do you see benefits or advantages to either perspective? And how is Estrella operating on this front?
Sure. So Estrella is actually, we just announced most recently that we're doing a Estrella Media ad sales. And this is actually a compilation between Estrella Media ad sales as well as beIN Sports and Hemisphere. It's a really great partnership. And this is something that really kind of evolved on the linear side, but we're bringing it across all of our video, display, and audio businesses. And that includes both the linear, terrestrial, as well as our digital side of the business. So that unification is very helpful for our direct sales team. So we're empowering our direct sales team to be able to, you know, really gain more momentum in the market and more recognition of the Hispanic marketplace, and especially the Hispanic audience, because it is a underserved market that we're trying to support. I think in addition to that, that's our direct sales team. We're very much also very open to programmatic. Programmatic is something that we are, you know, working very hard with our different ad servers, with our different demand partners to bridge. Because at the end of the day, when we have direct sales, which is a very, very great portion of what we do, programmatic is what's going to help us make sure that our entire pod is filled. It helps with the user's experience. And so if you see an ad pod, and let's say it's 2 minutes, but you only have a minute of direct sold demand, what else is going to happen there? It's going to be a house ad? We don't want that. We want to monetize on it. So instead of that house ad, we're going to replace it with programmatic demand. Another piece that I find with programmatic that's very helpful is there's direct sold programmatic, which is considered programmatic guaranteed, and there's also just open auction type of programmatic. So PMP is an open auction. I think one of the things that we're working very hard towards is that programmatic guaranteed. And the reason why we do that is because we see with VAST tags, or the traditional way of doing direct sales with digital, is that these VAST tags have a lot of or these VAST tags have a lot of VAST errors associated with it. So empty VAST responses. And I think this is an issue throughout the entire industry. So one of the things that we're doing to combat this issue is actually utilizing programmatic guaranteed, where there's a much more robust Q&A, there's much more troubleshooting available, reporting. And on top of that, a lot of times these systems or platforms that we're connected to, they're able to remove those VAST errors entirely. So for us, programmatic, while it is kind of this new, not necessarily new, but it's a way for us to do more open auction, it is also a way for us to kind of do more direct sales as well. So we're leaning into both of them.